chapter nouns and adjective. All the answer key I had forward to yesterday. You clear book and understand it. And so you know, so I'm just going to share a video. Just wait, all of you. Asta, can you hear?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, if any sound is not coming, Asta, I'm giving duty to Asta. You can unmute yourself and say, ma'am, unable to hear. Okay, continuing.
Pronoun. A pronoun is a word used instead of a noun. Pronouns is a word used instead of a noun. Like in our textbook we have, pronouns are words that are used in place of nouns. Pronouns agree with the nouns they replace in number and gender. So simple words we can say, pronoun is a word that...
I'm unable to hear.
Instead of a noun. Hurry is being repeated twice.
Here, once again, repeating it for you. A pronoun is a word used instead of noun. That's what we are learning. In lower class also, we had learned. A pronoun is a word that is being used instead of, in the place of noun. We are replacing the noun by using the pronoun. Examples are given. Hari is absent because Hari is ill. It does not look good because the name is repeated twice. Hari is absent because Hari is ill. Some kind of difficulty is there in the sentence. So it is better to avoid the repetition of the nouns. Like if you say, Jadin went to Agra, Jadin brought apple, it does not look good. So repetition of the names or the nouns, it has to be avoided in English sentences. So we are replacing that name, Hari, with the pronoun that is he. Since Hari is a noun, the male, gender. So what we are replacing with he. Hari is absent because he is ill.
Hari is absent because Hari is ill. It does not look good in the sentence. Names are repeated again and again. So instead of that,
I'm unable to hear
the repetition of Hari. There are different types of pronoun. Personal pronoun, reflexive pronoun, emphatic pronoun, indefinite pronoun, relative pronoun, demonstrative pronoun, interrogative pronoun, distributive pronoun, possessive pronoun. There are 9 types of pronouns. The first one, personal pronoun. What is the first one? Personal pronoun. In Hindi, we say Purushvachak Sarvanam. So what do you mean by personal pronoun? Personal pronoun are used in the place of names of people and things. They are used in the place of people and things. If a personal pronoun is the doer of the action, that is subject of the sentence, it is called a subject pronoun. If the pronoun receives the action done by the subject, it is called the object pronoun. I, we, you, he, she, it. They are called personal pronouns because they all stand for the 3 persons. The person speaking will be the first person. The person spoken to. That the one who is speaking, that will become the first person. The person spoken to, that is second person. This person spoken of, that will be the third person. Now I'm continuing with the next kind of pronoun, that is possessive pronoun. Possessive pronoun. Atiga vachak sarvana. Here, possessive pronoun means The pronoun which shows the possession or ownership is called possessive pronoun. What do you mean by possessive pronoun? The pronoun which shows the possession or the ownership is called possessive pronoun. For example, when you say my, mine, hers, yours, ours, etc. These are all possessive pronoun. So, for example, like if you say we bought two hats or the books are ours, this book is mine, it is my pencil, all this will become possessive. It is showing a mera hai, so something, it is showing possessiveness, possessive ownership of something.
One thing here you need to remember, why possessive show ownership, he said.
Ma'am, unable to hear.
We do not use possessive. Yes, Asta?
Ma'am, your voice is unable to hear.
Were you able to hear the video noise or voice?
Yes, ma'am.
That means now you are hearing me, correct?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, so one thing you need to remember, do not add an apostrophe when you say ours or yours. It is yours when you say we do not use an apostrophe in a possessive pronoun. I hope it is clear to you. While doing the examples, you will further understand. Continuing.
Next one we have, moving on with the next one, that is reflexive pronoun. Reflexive pronoun, nichvachak sarvanam. So that is reflexive pronoun. So what do you mean by reflexive pronoun? It represents the action performed by the subject is on the subject itself.
Excuse me, ma'am.
Reflexive pronoun.
Ma'am,
not able to hear us, sir.
Ma'am, now able.
So reflexive pronoun here, you are adding self. Self to some. That's you will understand. I looked at myself in the mirror. Okay. I looked at myself in the mirror. When you say, hope you can hear now.
Yes, ma'am.
So I looked at myself in the mirror. When you say here myself, the word myself, it becomes a reflexive pronoun. Please help yourself. Here also S-E-L-F, self is added to your. Please help yourself. Or the students solve the problems themselves. Here the word the is plural we are showing, so it becomes plural of self, it becomes selves. We'll continue with examples.
ma'am.
Mom, we can't hear.
Is it possible to hear Asta? Can you hear me, Asta?
Yes, ma'am.
That means the video audio is not coming. I shall play just now. You tell me whether you're. What is there in front of your screen, Asta? Can you read it out loudly?
Ma'am, difference between reflexive pronoun and emphatic pronoun. Reflexive.
Very good.
Pronoun.
Okay.
They are used okay. as.
Okay, you just listen now. Whether you're able to hear, you tell me. Okay.
Ma'am, no, ma'am, sound is not coming.
Not coming. Asta, now I shall start explaining the video, but in case the audio voice is coming, repeatedly two voices if you are hearing, you may just inform me, okay? So I'm continuing. Difference between reflexive pronoun and emphatic pronoun. They are used as subjects of the verb when the action of the
verb becomes the
tends to the doer. Sir,
excuse me, ma'am.
Here, subject is I. Yes.
Ma'am, yes, sir. Sometimes your voice is not coming.
Better that is just because of the network problem. Okay. I myself do not know what to do. It is because of the network. It is writing and showing here, but network quality. Now, can you hear me?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. They are used as objects of the verb when the action of the verb returns to the doer. The subject and the object of sentence are the same person in reflexive pronoun. Like I hurt myself. When you say I hurt myself, here is I and you're talking about myself only. I hurt myself, not about anybody else. But what happens in emphatic pronoun? They are used to emphasize noun or pronoun. Here, this same word like herself and himself and all is used. Now, let's go. Wrote the poem. Nobody else. No one helped me. I myself wrote the poem, or she herself opened the door. Something you are giving emphasis to the noun or the person who is doing, whatever it may be. So, continuing. difference between relative pronoun and interrogative difference between relative pronoun and interrogative pronoun. Relative pronoun it is used
when your voice is not coming.
If you are unable to hear, you may just kindly today. Rajat, tell me, are you unable to hear anything? Some problem?
Yes, ma'am. We are able to hear.
We were talking about emphatic pronoun and then continuing with interrogative pronoun. I just explained to you interrogative pronoun. Interrogative pronouns are used to ask questions. Interrogative pronoun, the word interrogative, you know, we ask questions like what, why, where. When all these WH words, when it is used, we say these are interrogative words. So interrogative pronouns are used to ask questions. The five interrogative pronouns are who, what, which, whom, and whose. These are interrogative words. For what are you searching for? When you ask all these questions, WH words, it becomes interrogative pronouns. Continue with the demonstrative pronoun. Demonstrative pronoun point to specific people and things. Demonstrative pronoun point out to specific people and things. They are like this, that, those, these, etc. When you talk about something near, you use this and that. Like this is a tree or this is a bird. But since something is very far, we say that is a tree or that is a bird. So in the case of plural nouns, we use these and those. These things you have already learned it. Yes, Rajat, you want to say something?
Relative pronoun is left in between.
Yes, whether got cut with the video, 1 minute. Okay, I hope now it's clear. Almost I can see the screen. So now what do you mean by indefinite pronoun? We have one type of pronoun, that is indefinite pronoun. Indefinite pronouns are used to talk about people or things in general. The word indefinite, when you hear, you know, something not definite, you are not specifically clearly or saying about noun or a pronoun. Indefinite pronouns that are used to talk about people or things in general. So for example, when you say anybody, someone, anything, everyone, what to say, few, all these words, there are many words written in your textbook itself. So all these words does not you are not clearly saying. General statements you are making. No one knows what happened. When you say no one knows what happened, it is the word no one becomes an indefinite noun. No one becomes an indefinite noun. So mostly I lost with the half of the video was not able to display. I shall send to you over the WhatsApp the full video what is being prepared. I shall forward it. You can listen once again. Because of the network problem, I was unable to play the video properly, and some you are telling you are not able to hear. So there is no use of displaying.